Hey everybody, it's Alex with Engineering Applied. We're going to be accelerating your career, hobby, or business with this overview of the available suite tool found in Autodesk Inventor. If you want more easy to understand and practical content made by an experienced engineer like myself, make sure you like this video, turn on notifications, and subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out on any helpful content like this in the future. Also, if you're looking for a specific function, make sure you check the description for timestamps. And if you don't find what you're looking for in this video, make sure you check out my other videos in the Autodesk Inventor series playlist, because I know you'll find exactly what you need there. Let's get started. Okay, so here we are in our blank part file. And what we're going to do first is we're going to go through how we create sketches to successfully utilize the sweep tool and how those sketches interact with the tool itself. So the first thing we're going to do is we need to sketch the cross-section shape of the swept profile. There's two sketch components for the basic sweep and then three for a guided sweep, but I'll go over that towards the end. So we need a cross-section profile, and then we need a guiding line. So what we're going to do first is just sketch a cross-section profile. I'm just going to sketch a rectangle. It'll just show us clearly what that sweep tool is doing. So we'll just use a corner rectangle. I'll just drop it here at the origin, one corner in the origin, and we'll just dimension it to 0.5 by 0.5. As always, guys, don't forget to fully dimension your sketches before you move on, because if you don't, it leaves room for error in the future when, let's say, somebody else jumps into your model. They might be looking at a sketch and they'll accidentally click and drag something and ruin your entire model by accident. So I've seen this happen before. Do yourself a favor and be diligent about constraining your sketches fully. Okay, so we're gonna just click finish sketch. Okay, so we've got our first sketch down. And so now we need our guiding line for this cross-section profile. So we're gonna create another 2D sketch, and I'm just going to create it on the XZ plane because we wanna sweep it along this direction. And two-dimensionally, we need that curve to lie on this plane for this to happen for us in the manner that we want it to. So we're going to click on this plane here. Okay, so you can do your guiding lines or your curves basically anywhere around the cross-section profile. So generally what I'll do is I'll connect the curve to either a corner or maybe central, centered up to this curve here. So maybe if you had a center point and that's the area you wanted to pick up, that's perfectly acceptable. It really just depends on your design intent and what you're trying to do with your specific model. But in this case, we're just gonna pick up the corner here. Okay, so we'll just drop down here, and I'm just gonna use an interpolated spline just to show this example. So we'll just start at the corner, and I'm just gonna just arbitrarily create a curve here. It really doesn't matter what it looks like. It's just to display the tool for you. And we'll have it terminate there. That looks fine, okay. All right. Now, one thing I would like to point out is generally for my sweeps, I like for this curve to be perpendicular with the cross-section profile so that when it starts the sweep, it's the cross-section shape is maintained from the start. So to do that, I'll show you how I can do that now. So we'll go back into the sketch, and what you can actually do, let me rotate this real quick. So what you can do is you can drop just a regular line. So what I'll do is I'll pick up the corner, bring it out, make sure it's perpendicular to this, click OK. And I like to set this as construction just to keep everything in line. And then you can use the smooth tool up in the constrain section. So if you just click that, you can click these two lines and it'll smooth that line out so it comes in, you know, where we want it up here in the corner. So we can click OK. We'll finish the sketch there. Okay, now we have the basics for creating the sweep. So now what we're going to do is go up to sweep under the create section. Okay, you'll notice it actually already picks up my profile and it picks up the curve. Sometimes it doesn't do that if you have multiple curves or multiple profiles. It doesn't know all the time what you want to pick. But for the most part, it's a pretty intelligent decision software-wise. It does a pretty good job at doing that. Okay, I'm gonna skip down here on the bottom. So usually if you're accustomed to my videos, I start in the top left and work my way to the right and down. But I do wanna just point out an option under the advanced property section. It's optimized for single selection. So basically what this allows us to do is say, for example, it didn't pick anything up. If this is not selected, and you'll notice when I click that profile, it's still keeping the profile section active with that little blue line. Now, if I had this checked, it would allow me to pick one profile and it would automatically jump to the path selection just to help streamline my process. Now, if you want to maintain full control over your process, I would recommend keeping this unchecked. But if you generally only work with one curve and one profile at a time, this is a great option for you because it sort of saves you that extra little step of going back and forth. And it doesn't seem like a big deal, but these little time savers really add up over the long run of your design process. So that's my little tidbit on that. So I'll just click that and show that to you now. So I have that checked. Click that and you'll see it jumps automatically to path, and I can click my path and then I'm ready to rock and roll. So, okay, so that's that option there. So I'm going to uncheck that. Now, moving up to the top, we have our properties tab. If you hit this X, it closes out of the sweep tool. This little plus allows us to add extra menus. Okay, here we have our advanced settings menu. So the first option is hide presets. All this does is so here we have our presets menu. If we click that, it'll hide that menu. We will uncheck that to reveal that menu again. And then this next option here is single enter to finish command. Simply put, we hit the enter key once and it finishes the command. So I'll just show you that real quick here. So we'll select a profile. It's already picked up our curve, and I'll just hit enter once and it finishes the command. If I uncheck that, I have to hit enter twice to finish the command. So maybe I'm adding a taper value or a twist value to the sweep. I hit enter once, it locks in that number. I hit it again, then it closes out of the command and applies it. So let's actually jump back into this. Okay, moving down here, we can actually edit the name on the fly of this feature. So this sweep feature, we can actually change the name of this. So maybe we wanna call it example. We can press enter. And when we finish this command, it'll actually update this feature with that name. So if I were to hit okay over here on the left, you'll see that it's named example. So that's a really handy tool. Okay, let's go back into sweep. Moving over here, we have solid mode and surface mode. So currently it's in solid mode. So when I hit okay, it's going to create a solid body. If I click this little toggle here, it switches to surface mode. So if I hit okay, you'll notice that the color is different and it's just a series of surfaces. So if you want to create a swept surface, you can absolutely do that. Go back into the tool once more. Okay, over here we have our preview mode. So we can toggle our preview mode on and off. So currently it is on. So we see sort of that green profile showing us what this will look like when we finish the command. We click that and that'll go away. So just depending on your preference, that's available to you. Moving down, this is our preset menu. So what this allows us to do is it allows us to create some presets of all of the parameters we typically use for the sweep function. So let's say, for example, I commonly design spindles for a staircase. So that's that little metal structure. Sometimes they're decorative, and so they're sort of have a twist to it with a little basket in the middle. And so say I use the sweep tool to accomplish that task, I can create a custom profile that I can refer back to without having to manually enter or look up the values over and over again. So how we do that is we go up to this little plus sign, we create a new preset, and I'll just call it, preset one, it really doesn't matter. And then you hit this little check mark that saves the name. Okay, now when we go to our dropdown, all of the parameters we had entered for this preset are available to us. Now, let's say we want to delete a certain preset. What we can do is we can make sure the preset of interest, that is the preset that we want to delete, is already selected. And then we can come over to this little settings menu button. We click that and you'll notice there's some options here. We could save it, rename it, and delete it. Of course, change our sort order and so on and so forth. In this case, we want to delete it, so we'll click delete. And there you go. So if we pull down that drop-down menu, we no longer have that example preset there. Now let's move down to input geometry. So input geometry, again, is where we select our inputs for the sweep function. So our first option is profiles. So this would be our cross-section shape that we're interested in sweeping along a curve, okay? And if you want to deselect something, all you have to do is click this little X that's next to it. The same applies for the path. So this is that guiding curve that allows us to sweep this shape along that path. That could be lines, that could be circles, an ellipse. As you see here, I use the spline. So it's just whatever fits your design profile, that'll work for you. And then down here in the behavior section, this controls our output. So we have our orientation selection. So our first orientation selection basically takes that cross-section shape, and then it maintains that orientation perpendicular to the curve that you're guiding it along. Now, if we were to use this next option, which is fixed, you'll notice that the shape, and let me go to the end here because it's exaggerated, the shape stays oriented in the same direction that it stayed in the beginning. And you'll notice at the end, as the curve moves around to the left here, it sort of creates a tapered shape. That's because we're using this particular fixed orientation option. If I go back to the original, the follow path, it ends as that same cross section that we started. So just always bear that in mind and use that as needed. Now, this last option is our guided option. I'll jump back to that one after I touch on these two options here and how to use that, because we'll need to add a sketch element and we'll do something a little different there. So now you'll notice this little drop down arrow. If we click that, it's our selector style option. So currently it's set to icons. That's what I prefer. Now, if we change this to drop down, it gives you a little drop down menu to select those options as well. It's a little bit more consolidated in a different manner. So it just really depends on how you like to see your menus. Okay, so the next option is taper. And what taper does for us is it allows us to do exactly what it says here and either taper the shape down, make it smaller, or taper it outwards or grow the part as it moves along the curve. So we can type just some number in here. I'll just type one. Because since this curve is pretty long with reference to the cross section itself, it makes a big difference as it goes along the path. So you'll see that it grows along the curve. Now I can do the exact opposite. I can type, let's do negative 0.5, and it sort of tapers down to a smaller cross section in reference or in comparison to what it started. So that's what the taper option does for you. The next option is twist. And what twist allows us to do is it allows us to rotate the cross section. It allows us to twist the cross section as it goes along the guiding curve. So I'm going to start out at 360 degrees here, and you'll notice that that cross section twists about as it goes along that curve. We can either increase this or decrease this. So I can always multiply that by two. Okay, it gives us more of a twist, or I can decrease it. So I can set it down to 180 degrees and we have less twists as we go along. So that's your twist option there. Now, I want to come over to this side of both the taper and twist boxes because we have this little arrow that faces to the right. If we click on this, it gives us the option to pick up feature dimensions or to measure a dimension in our part and use that to create the parameter for taper or twist. So this is very similar to the extrude function, revolve, and some of the other 3D geometry creation tools. So it works the same way as it works in those other tools if you're familiar with that. So let's say, for example, I wanted to pick up a dimension in my part. I could use the measure tool and then use that measured dimension to go directly to my taper or my twist value. Okay, the same thing with feature dimension, but it picks up the feature dimension itself. So depending on what you're trying to do with your design, these are very valuable tools to help streamline your design process. Now, I want to go back and talk about the guide orientation option. So for this example, we're going to delete the sketches that we currently have, and we're going to create some new sketches to utilize this tool. So we need our cross-section shape, we need a guiding line, and then we need our rail to guide the outer profile of the shape. Now, in this example, we'll just start out with a small circle, and we'll want to expand the base of the circle into sort of like a cone shape. So first, let's cancel out of this and delete these sketches. Okay. Go up to start 2D sketch. We'll just create the cross section on this plane here. We'll center it up with the origin and we'll dimension it to 1/4 inch. Click OK. we'll finish that sketch there. Now we need to create our path line. So we'll just create it on the XZ plane. Just use a standard line and bring it out to some arbitrary distance. Okay, that looks good. Finish this one. Okay, now we need to create the guiding rail that controls the outer profile of our shape. So we'll create one more sketch and we'll do it on the XZ plane. And so let's get some geometry sketched up here real quick. So I'm going to project the endpoint here because I want it to stop here. Okay, we'll just convert this to reference, bring out a line here. And let's say that we want it to have a radius of, 0.757 is fine. Okay, convert this to construction. Okay, now we need to project this circular geometry so that we can pick up the edge of the circle here. We'll convert that to construction, bring out a line. Okay, I'm just picking up the endpoint there, which is the coincident with that edge of that circle, bringing it out here. Okay, so now we have our guiding rail. We'll click finish. All right, now let's rotate our sketch around and we'll go to sweep. So it picks up our profile. We need to select our path. It's this. This is our path because we still want it to go in this direction. Now our guide rail or our guide line is going to actually create that 3D geometry. So it's going to expand that circle out to this radius that we've created here. So we'll just pick up this line here. So make sure that's selected with the little blue line underneath there. Click that. And now you'll notice we achieved our desired shape using the sweep tool. Now you can use this whichever way you deem necessary for your particular design. But I just wanted to show you this example because this is one way that you could utilize this. Okay, so now we've got our profile there and we can click OK. Okay, so there are a couple other options under the guide parameter that we haven't discussed yet. So let's hit Control Z. We'll go back into the sweep command. Now let's reselect our path. We'll reselect our guide rail. Okay, go down to the profile scaling section and we have three options. By default, it's set to X and Y scaling. The next option is X scaling. So X scaling essentially scales the part only in the X direction. So you see with X and Y direction, it does it both in the X and Y direction. But here it will only do it in the one axis direction. Okay, so you can create some pretty complex geometry with a simple tool. Okay, and then the final option is no scaling. So that's not going to allow the part to scale at all. And of course, at the end here, you have this little selector style menu dropdown. So you can choose your selector style of choice. And the final button that we have here is our apply and create new sweep option. So basically what this does is it applies the current set of parameters, but it keeps the sweep command window open for subsequent use. So you don't have to hit enter and then go back up to sweep again. So if you know that you're going to use this command several times in a row, this is a convenient way to do that. And it just speeds up your workflow a little bit there. That's all for this segment of the Autodesk Inventor Part Creation Module, where we took a look at the available sweep tool. Don't forget to like this video, subscribe to my channel, and turn on notifications to stay up to date on future content that will absolutely help you reach your goals along your journey. And of course, as always, guys, don't hesitate to leave a comment or reach out via my website contact page, and let me know if there's anything else you'd like to learn about or see on my channel. I really appreciate you choosing to learn with me, and I'll see you again soon.